as Washington territory grew, the push for statehood occurred, and February 22nd, 1889, statehood was granted through an enabling act that basically laid out what was required of the territory to become a state. Everything that a state would need to run was laid out in this act. With the Enabling Act came the race for capital. Ellensburg said, "We're the center of the state, we should be capital." We built a governor's mansion. The hope was so high.
Reality is, all of those hopes and dreams are out the window in just 4 hours.
Ellensburg, as it grew, was a bustling town, especially once the railroad came through in 1886. There were a lot of people who came seeking fortunes. Buildings were made out of wood. It was kind of a slightly lawless town, but John Shouty, town founder, said we could be the capital if Washington Territory was to become a state, and that he was able to encourage the railroad when they built to cross the Yakima River twice, which was an additional cost to the railroad and highly unusual. Ellensburg said, "We're the center of the state, we should be capital."
In 1888, the press was Ellensburg was going to be, there wasn't any ifs, ands, or was going to be the state capital. And that all of the big players within the process were saying, Ellensburg is the only place, because it's right directly in the middle of the state, that it's equal distant for anybody to come to be a part of the state politics, and that many of the people in Ellensburg were elected to positions that were state positions. Shouty served on a number of committees that played into Washington becoming a state. Reality is, all of those hopes and dreams are out the window.
July 4th, the delegates sequestered themselves in Olympia. That same day at 10:30 p.m., shouts of fire rang out through Ellensburg. 10 downtown blocks and the homes of 200 people burned in a matter of 4 hours. The fire started at J.S. Anthony's Blue Front store. Today, in 2017, that location is occupied by the Iron Horse Brew Pub. The fire, though, whipped so fast and so furious that it melted brick like candle wax and was seen glowing in the night sky from Yakima. The cisterns were bone dry. The Yakima River was running low, and there was really no way with the wind and wooden buildings to put the fire out. Within a couple days, people were crying, "Well, who did this to us?" To today, we don't know. That's Ellensburg's greatest mystery.
Then what are you going to do with this kind of disaster, with all of this expectation that you were going to be the center of the universe? A day or two after the fire, they have a meeting in the street. Things are still smoldering. They say some people who had committed early on and that had ordered the things to be a building were still willing to do that. Those people who had lost everything said, "Well, I think I can find financing and that I'll go ahead." There's a whole level of cooperation and survival of a disaster that doesn't happen today. And that from July 4th to early November is the time period, which is just a little over 90 days, they rebuild 2- and 3-story brick buildings into all of those spots that had little wooden buildings. At the time, they said it was $2 million worth of damage. The reality is, here's a community that's willing to work together, willing to put all of their resources in the bucket and to share both the construction people and the make your own resources, lumber and brick and all the rest, in order that this is some cool place that is show-stopping and prestigious for its time.
After the fire, the vote was cast for her state capital in October 1889. Not one city really came in with a clear majority win. Olympia had about 23,000 votes. Yakima had about 13,000, and Ellensburg around 8. So the following year, 1890, they recast the vote. And at that point, it was a clear victory for Olympia with over 30,000 voters. North Yakima had about 8, and Ellensburg only registered around 3,000. After the loss of capital, there were a number of businesses and just the community kind of rallied together, keeping those businesses going. We moved forward.
We're all working for the same future, and I think that that's definitely the uniqueness of downtown Ellensburg.